had some wonderful, outstanding presentation. Is April here?
Yeah, right here.
Oh, good. She's going to give us at least two questions to think about. We will not have time for the walk. So we just have to live with that.
So I think, of course, this was a wonderful session, and I feel like we should start the second half of the conference now, because that's where we really are, is we're ready to work. So I think a good question to ask, I asked myself, was what you found most inspiring about these presentations for you, because that becomes the basis of your motivation. Very important question. So think about that for a few minutes, a few seconds, is what inspires you. And then we could probably cut to the chase and say, how can we work together in the future to further theosophic social responsibility? How can we do that? So I think we're on the brink of really going for it. We can do it on an individual level, we can do it in our groups, our organizations, and we can do it as a movement. So maybe we could brainstorm some ideas for how to do that, and that will be a basis for further interaction with each other. Okay? So the first question is, what inspires you about what's going on? And the second is, how can we work together? How can we brainstorm ways to work together to further theosophic social responsibility? Okay, so let's just take till 3 minutes and be silent and just let's see what bubbles up, and then we'll talk.
The love that I feel in this room is one of the most powerful things I've ever felt. And just to look at everyone's faces and the expression of feeling you get from that is a very, very powerful thing.
That's a great way to start it out. Thanks, Jim. So we could have, we're going to do this in short fashion, but good 5 minutes where we just respond to what inspired us. And Marijn, he has the microphone, right? And so anyway, one would like to contribute to that, please, we'll just build on each other's enthusiasm. Anyone? Good. Hi.
Microphone. Okay. Good morning, and I feel so honored, and so I'm so grateful that I attended this conference. It's been very successful, very inspiring, meeting people from so many different places. It's just amazing, and I wake up today feeling different than when I first came and trying to understand how the thoughts and the feeling change and evolve of you every minute that go by, actually, and how I starting to connect more with this movement, and how full of energy and inspiration I'm going back to Los Angeles with. And thank you so much, brothers and sisters. This is a great, great, great privilege to be here, and I hope that you will continue to do this wonderful event all over the world. I congratulate all of you from all over the world, everybody who have been part of this, and the people who helped founded this movement, and Dr. Colbert and Sally, which is no longer with us. I mean, she's here with the spirit. And all I can say is that what inspired me the most is the brotherly feelings, and I love the groups, those cluster meetings, because I think it's extremely important that we interact, exchange thoughts. What they say, one candle lights the other. And when you have conference and it's just talk and not interaction, you don't have that participation. since you don't have input, and therefore, how can we exchange ideas so that we can grow together and become a community? So I thought that the circle, those group committees that we did, I think they were a fabulous idea. I hope that I encourage that will continue as well. Thank you.
Yes, what words can be said? This is indeed one of the best sessions I've ever been in. The question is not what to do, but how to get the time to do it. There's so many wonderful ideas here, so many wonderful organizations. All the different groups have everything I've heard I like, that I'd like to be part of and help. I'm thinking of other ways I can do it with the time you have, etc. But it is indeed one of the best sessions I've ever had. And yes, the study groups I very, very much like. I like the closer interaction and the interaction and ideas were expressed, I think, a lot more clearly in these groups, but also in general. So thank you so much, and continue the great work.
I want to thank everyone who's contributed to the organization of this conference and the wonderful speakers. And everyone has made a contribution. About this particular session, I was very impressed just with all the information given out. I knew, for example, that Catherine Tingley had made an important contribution to Theosophy by founding the Theosophical University in Point Loma and then the whole Point Loma group, but I didn't know about her engagement with these kings of Europe, King Oscar, the Tsar of Russia at The Hague, and her attempt to really use practical theosophy. And I have heard, although I don't have it confirmed, that Prince Charles of England once made the statement that he would like to embrace all the religions of England. Of course, being the Prince of Wales, he has to be Anglican. And he said if he ever becomes king, he would like to feel in that way. And I have heard that he believes in reincarnation, but can't really talk about it. But I just want to generally say that we have an intense feeling of unity now, and that I think this wipes out the history of divisions that we've had. We're wiping it out right now.
Yeah, I came with low expectations. I came, actually, my mother and sisters live in Santa Barbara, so that's why I came. I thought I got a 2-for-1. And the reason I didn't have real high expectations, well, one thing usually, you know, I've gone to a lot of theosophical conferences over the years, and you go and you kind of have a good time and you eat some food, and then nothing happens afterwards. I mean, you know, it's not like, it doesn't open up that much. It's kind of a nice, you know, thing to happen, and that's it. Another reason was that I thought social responsibility. I'm a Buddhist, and when people start talking about social responsibility, it's sort of saying, let's do something for the environment. And if I want to do something for the environment, I join Greenpeace or Friends of the Earth. That's kind of how I feel. And so I was wondering, okay, why can't Theosophy just stick to what it's supposed to do, whatever that is? And actually, what we did was here was what Theosophy is supposed to do, I think. That was, to me, was the real thing I'm taking home. Because a bunch of people came together, and there's a lot of real serious students, a lot of people have thought a lot. And we kind of come feeling, with all the stuff we studied and we've read, and we just want to share it, you know? It's like in every group, you know, everyone was raising their hand, everyone wanted to talk, and everyone wanted to listen. And I think we're going away with that feeling, too, maybe even more. And that's how Carolyn talked about creating a center of light. And I think that's our social responsibility, what we can do with each other. And it starts there, and I think that this will really help me to go back to Japan and start circles of, you know, light.
I do want to say we started with the title, Theosophy and Social Responsibility, and maybe the title needs to be Theosophic Social Responsibility, because they're the same. They're the same. So we don't have much time, and we really need to think about, because we're all inspired, how can we work together in the future as theosophists to further social responsibility theosophically through different ways. And this needs to be a brainstorming. So at this point, it's just about being creative and letting your right brain loose. And so we can form a list of possibilities. And then there's all kinds of ways we can go about later, thinking about projects, the next conference, that kind of thing. But we need some seeds. We need some seeds for thought as to directions we can go in. So let's turn towards that. And I think Erwin was going to help me and try to write down those lists of possibilities so that we can follow up on them later. So, Brett, did you have? Okay. Anyone want to just let your right brain go? No censoring, no censoring. Just what are possibilities? What ideas can we come up with? Jack.
I think ITC is really demonstrating its capability to have everyone together on a single line of thoughts. And now we are talking and looking for action. We've also seen through the presentation this morning that action toward the world is needed. So why couldn't we think about ITC bearing ITC, yes, ITC, the people of ITC, which is everyone around, okay? Bearing the theosophical philosophy in the international organization, like UN, UNESCO, and whatever you think, where it can be a real force, a real presence there.
Say that we as an ITC group ought to make our presence known in some kind of public manner. Is that
correct? Let's say that the philosophy of the theosophy needs to be brought out to the world, mm-hmm. and that could be a channel.
Okay, let's just list it up. Good. And I think, did I see? You have one? Oh, no, don't contain yourself.
Related to that idea, I think it would be wonderful if ITC were able to reach out to the current interfaith movement that is so strong internationally, and together then perhaps with the influencing the UN. I mean, if we look to what Eleanor Roosevelt was able to accomplish mm-hmm. at the UN, mm-hmm. you know, what if the interfaith movement and ITC got together with them?
Great. Great. So this is a time to just think of possibilities. Good. Helena.
Thank you. Apropos of what Richard mentioned, taking that pause and the time after the conference to digest and reaching out to the things, because we exchanged a lot of information, mm-hmm. and there are things that are out there, mm-hmm. you know, that exist, and following through when we go home, but making the time, because we're all busy people,
right.
I know that,
right.
and we do a lot, but just, you know, taking that 10 minutes once a week to say, hey, let me connect to somebody at ITC.
Great.
I think it's important to keep our theosophical identity, and I'm encouraging every theosophical organization, society, etc., to establish in their website projects that they're working on, mm-hmm. like the TOS that mm-hmm. that Carol showed us, and the Hague work is very impressive. So we can feel theosophically mm-hmm. Where our values go to help. You know, where is our inner suffering matches the outer work of the society. I think that Joy Mills once told me that we cannot lose, Martin, our sense of belonging to the society, to the theosophical work. If we lose that, there will be no theosophy as an organization. Mm-hmm. Theosophy with a big T will be forever. So what I'm encouraging is all the groups to actually post it, list it, what they're working on. And then as we page through them, some really are close mm-hmm. to our heart. Mm-hmm. And like my brother from Japan, you know, he said, Greenpeace, of course we cannot do some of the works that they can do, or put our body in front of a whale, you know, and so on, right? But you know, but we do what we can do, mm-hmm. but I would like to keep it theosophically speaking. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Great. Jen, up here.
I'm listening to this and I'm thinking on a couple different levels. One.
Stand up.
One is what we can do as a group, as our local groups. But also, I'm thinking on another level, what can we do as individual theosophists? Mm-hmm. So I think we need to explore both of those. A lot of times, we don't have a big group, but we can volunteer individually. Mm-hmm. I think both of those opportunities are there. We should also think about not trying to reinvent the wheel. There are a lot of good organizations out there doing wonderful work. As long as we investigate and see if their values correspond with ours, and then we join with them, do the work, communicate, network, individually spread the ideas. But the groups or the individuals don't have to reinvent the wheel.
Great. Oh, we have one in the back. Okay, one in the back.
You kept me running, huh?
We'll go a few more minutes, and then we're going to have to close, so we give Gene a chance to close.
Hospice has taken an unholy place in supposedly seeing a compassionate ending to human life. I'd like to see us provide a much higher and more enlightened alternative.
Good. Well, could you repeat that so we could get it down again?
Could you repeat?
Yes. We should, as theosophists, find a way to provide a better exit from life strategy than is currently being provided by hospice.
And I think I saw over here, over on that side. We'll get you.
Can I react on both of these?
Just brainstorming.
No, whole ITC was for me a bowl of theosophical life's experience. All those people I talk to knew more about subjects than I know. And that is how we can help each other. Okay. Because when we organize an end-of-life activity, then it would be so nice if your life experience in that field as a theosophist is sent by us. And when you organize something about feeding the poor, then you can have our experience. Right. And that is what I like to exchange, your political experience, Carolyn's, and your, I want to drink from that bowl when we do something. Yes, otherwise we have to invent our theosophical ideas, how to express it, and that is how we can help each other.
So we need to communicate.
Yes.
Continuously.
For quite some months now, I've been a volunteer at a VA hospital at a hospice with Vietnam vets. And I'm not sure what I would do as a student of theosophy along the line other than to be with them and to communicate with them. I would never claim the wisdom to know to do anything other than that. That being said, also, with regard to social responsibility, sometimes the question arises in a theosophical lodge on abortion. And it would be helpful to learn and to understand how to sensitively and theosophically correctly educate the person asking the question. Mm-hmm. One article that was written, of mm-hmm. course, there's one by HPB, mm-hmm. but another one which is fantastic was written by Sally Colbert that mm-hmm. I would encourage everybody to read.
I also have very much appreciated being here with all of you this weekend. One thread that I've heard weave its way through our gathering is that has resonated with me, and it's my own words for it, is that the ideas are far more significant and important than the label we give the ideas. And I raised my hand at the same time as my brother Martin, and I'm saying something that to me feels a little bit diametrical, which is that we can work in the world, we can build coalitions without necessarily having our first foot forward be our membership in a theosophical tradition.
Right, right.
Because those ideas are so powerful. And I don't think this is a contradiction, I think it's maybe an expression of the second fundamental, it's the duality of how we might do this. Some of us have work to do from within the society outwards, some of us can take the teachings of the society that are embedded in us and participate in the world without necessarily expressing them in using the theosophical terminology.
I'm thinking about that and the comment made yesterday, which everybody resonated with. How do we find different ways to reach people about theosophy that know nothing about it in different contexts, which might be an excellent conference theme. So.
Over here.
I have to get away from the speaker.
We'll take we'll take one or two more and then we'll stop so we can wrap up.
I want to say that the readings I found really valuable addition this year, really good, because I had the feeling this year for the first time we really studied together. Mm-hmm. And if you remember the study method that Joak was talking about, we can do at home, read everything, form the first vision, but here we have the ultimate chance to practice with each other, to say it in our own words and do the thing that is needed to your own words, so you can at home spread theosophy, not in a technical teaching, but the way you have understood it and you have heard others understood it. I think that's really valuable.
Continue the study circle method.
Yes.
At home. And one more, and then okay. You gave it away.
I think we should all get involved in a theosophical order of service. I'm a member of the healing group, and I find it very, very rewarding. Thank you.
Okay. Do you want, I see one more enthusiastic person. Sorry, didn't see it.
No, that's fine. Thank you. I was just thinking, if part of our duty is to bring in our capabilities and abilities and qualities to the whole, in order for the whole to benefit from them, we need to know of them. So this is somewhat in the line of what Johanna was saying. Maybe we should exchange our qualities. That's quite an easy thing to do. And maybe we could do that by email or something. But now I know you are all about Gandhi. And now I know you are all about Plato. So now I know how to find you. But there are so many more people here that I don't know what their abilities are. So that was my thing.
Did you want to? And then we'll let Jean wrap it up.
Right. Well, this has been a wonderful experience, and all of you already said those words, and gives us a lot of energy. And it's of course because of the work, the wonderful work of the people locally here in Santa Barbara, and the initiative of ITC to organize these kind of things. My question to all of you is, can you do such a thing in your own country, in your own organization, in your own town where you live? Can you do something similar without ITC taking the initiative? And my question would be, who wants to be first? Huh? to organize such a thing, to keep on keeping on doing this work, because we all, I think I've said that it is very important.
Okay, so let's give all of us a hand. So I think we'll turn it over to Jean, who wants to...